they just ran through it like it wasn't even there. Is there a mod? Surely there's a mod someone's made that. But the only problem is I only have one mod on at a time. Because since I've got the rope sprinters on. But I wonder if someone's actually made a mod. Surely they have, that makes it so they just automatically sprint as soon as you start. Like as soon as the game literally starts. Instead of them being walkers, they automatically start sprinting. The whole atmosphere on this map though is sick, where you start where you hear things, like things running off roof and stuff. And then there's this door. There's someone in there. Turned into Left 4 Dead. Death toll. Are another game that I absolutely just absolutely played the shit out of. And I think Left 4 Dead is generally the one game that I didn't actually mind playing with people, since you had to play with people. If you especially wanted to do like expert, but Because I actually used to be in a team as well for that, for Left 4 Dead. It was actually quite well known as well. Sometimes though that did bring a problem, because if ever we wanted to play online, play versus, we couldn't because people see us and obviously automatically left because they knew who we were. So we obviously created, well, I wasn't up for doing it, created like different accounts and stuff so we could play, but one of dudes, he made me another account so I could play on it. Just play Left 4 Dead on it. But the funny as he is, when he was making the accounts, he decided to make it so the names were basically like pronames, you can kind of say, for the game. Mine, the one that he made for me, was Retro Boomer. It's like, oh yeah, let's just put like a pro name with like one of the special infected on the game. And then you've just got like a team that's got like pro names within the special infected name. I used to play on Left 4 Dead, Left 4 Dead 1. Left 4 Dead 1's better than Left 4 Dead 2, guarantees. Left 4 Dead 1, it was more team based. It was guaranteed more team based because of the whole point system. You had to play as a team if you wanted to like win. If you literally had two teams that knew how to play the game, they were pretty, like, literally no-lifed it. The game lasted hours. Since like everyone knew selves, best places to stay when you're doing the horde situations. Had two teams that knew how to play the game. It was so much fun. But back on Left 4 Dead 2, they made it so, well, I should say, sorry, on Left 4 Dead 1, they made it, the point system was based on your health of the players. So the more health you had, the more points you got if you went into the safe room, And you also got bonus points if you had a med kit. So it's like, oh, you don't want to use a med kit because you gain more points. But then back on Left 4 Dead 2, they just totally just got rid of that and just made it so it was just distance travel. So if you literally had two teams. Well, it's like even if you just had a team that knew how to play the game, went up against randoms. The randoms just got absolutely slaughtered. Since it was obviously changed it so it was distance traveled within the points. And then you've got a little bit of a bonus for how many people survived. And it's like, yeah, as soon as you generally just start, you just run. You don't think, you just go, just run. That's what kind of killed it off for me. It wasn't really, generally the one franchise that I generally think it was a perfect team game. That's why Left 4 Dead 1 versus just far better. It's like the game knows, it's waiting. I want to get sleight of hand, but I ain't going in that room. And then Back for Blood came out, and it's a shame that they just totally changed the verses for it. They just changed it into the survival mode back on Left 4 Dead 2. And the biggest problem for Back 4 Blood, the balancing for it was just absolutely all over the place. Especially if you played on expert, if you played on the hardest difficulty on the campaign. Since it's got the whole thingy system, I forgot the name of it. Is it the Nemesis system? That's what they called it. Where the game adapts on how the players are playing and whatnot. And let's just make it so the tank of the game, that's like the tank from Left 4 Dead. Let's make that like the charger, but it's got health of a tank. Oh, I'm just sitting in this room. I'm gonna go through this door, and it literally spawns one literally round the fucking corner, and it's like, yeah, what have I got? An SMG with a pistol going up against a tank generally within the first 5 seconds of starting the game. The balancing was just absolutely horrendous. But yeah, back on Left 4 Dead, they made it so if there was a tank in the map, it automatically spawned. But it was in that one place, so you could hear him, and it only spawned in that one place. It didn't just, I'm in this room now, and then it just spawns it around this corner of the door. It was generally the one thing that it was just absolutely horrendous for. It was just the spawns system. It was just absolutely garbage. It's generally the one game that you're doing absolutely perfectly fine on. You've got perfect health, everything supplies, and then literally within the next second, you've lost it all. Because it just spawns a fucking tank around the corner. It was even kind of the same for Left 4 Dead 2 with Charger. Because it's same again. The Charger had a lot of health. And it can just run up to you and punch you literally three times and you died. And the amount of times when I was playing that game, the amount of times that I got accused of using fucking aimbot and shit. It's actually kind of ironic as well, but when I actually generally brought this to play custom zombies since like when I got my new computer. Got Steam and whatnot. And it literally had to have in a sale the games. In Left 4 Dead 1 and 2. In Left 4 Dead 1 and 2 it was, I think it was like £1.25, and I'm like, hey, that's insane. £1.25 for Left 4 Dead 1 and 2. Especially a map that doesn't have Deadshot. Is that powerful? Desert Eagle, is that powerful? It even kills me. This seems powerful as well. Oh. I want to use these, but I don't. Since it's made of timber. Fucking RPG. The one shotgun. Same again, it's from COD 4. The one shotgun that absolutely looks sick with the grip. Even the trench gun. Trench guns were from World of War. That looks sick. Grip attachment on it as well. Even in that, it's like, probably like... This is probably like one of the best looking shotguns as well. Obviously the flash shotgun is better because of the fire rate. Normal to the evil. The one, this is the one from Modern Warfare 2. The other one from Modern Warfare 4, the gold one. It makes it akimbo. Whoever thought it was a good idea back on COD, it's even on World at War. You can fire guns as fast as you can basically tap it. Whoever thought that was a good idea. Fucking hell. running around with a fucking Desert Eagle. He's firing like an SMG. I can only do it. I can only do it one form. Well, one. Oh, the G3. This is on the wall. And this is probably without a doubt the best ever. Same again, it's not fucking COD 4. The G3 is probably the best ever single fire weapon. On any Call of Duty. And if you had the, and it's probably the best sounding suppressed weapon on Call of Duty as well. So it's like ting 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 ting. To do a cartwheel.
Think you're on the nice list, do you?
Say this is a bad idea. It's actually a pretty cool spot to sit though, because the spawner is quite fast. Thank you. Good job, the map makers made it so easy.
It is.
Good, try to use his gun.
I don't know why I have
to. I'm curious. Then if the map had flopper. Yeah, it's just kinda ironic that the person that made this map likes the colour purple, but yeah, flopper's not on that. Is it same again? I never thought that were a good idea. Shoot a fucking pirate sniper. Like, fucking SMG. Boomstick. Look at the mark of their finger. Going out. I wonder if you got the P90s, I wonder if you pack a punch it and it makes them akimbo. I wonder if it makes this akimbo. No, but the fire rate is insane. Where the hell's the box? If only if they made this single fire. They're technically dead on Alpha Omega. Well, obviously it was a variant. Now this is where the game will give me a max ammo. First kill. This is where having your kick is like a good idea since the fact since you've got two weapons that can automatically just kill them, but then you can get insta kill. You've got your kick, you can just get the weapon that doesn't only kill them in one hit. And you can just spray them. a bowie knife somewhere. It's in the kitchen. It's in the kitchen. Oh, saying that. Thermal grenades from the box. I thought that were a thing. Thermal grenades would be good for insta. First time, come on, do it. I somehow killed that zombie before the claymore. Unless the claymore here, we didn't kill her.
Yeah.
Kaboom! Oh, see, in game on that there. Make it full of yards. Mate, it's like it's. Is it just doing it for that? It is. Oh. The Regal Mark II's got like full on aim assist. Genuinely insane, like Regal Mark II, full on god, full on like full aim assist, fucking auto fucking aim. Since I don't really like playing with auto aim assist, sorry. so glad though that they changed it. Because I think they changed it from, I think it was Advanced Warfare when they full and like changed it.
Safe, because if you turn it off.
Target aim assist, but it's still got the auto aim thing, whatever you call it. This map's different though, because it's not doing it with these weapons. Someone goes to playing piano. I just don't know why I just find it so funny when it's the Baroque sprinters. I don't know why I just find it funny when they're running. Especially when they're 30. They're just running around. Just running around one tapping them. I should get a max ammo thing if I do not. Oh. Game's not going to... Oh! I was going to say, I was literally just about to say, the game's not going to let me get up them stairs. Because I was thinking of just going by special shotgun off at wall. That is definitely a good weapon to have. Especially when you pack a punch. Because even in a funny way as well, I generally thought turn didn't actually kill the zombies. Like, it killed them, but it didn't like count towards the actual wave kill. It just respawned them. I generally thought that's what it did for some reason. Watch it, give me thermals right now. Watch, thermals. The good old M16. Not one shot, I think. Well, sometimes it isn't, sometimes it ain't. Seems to be the actual skeleton zombies. They seem to sponge a shot.